What's up, everybody out there in quarantine land? This is your host of the One Stone Dude podcast, Ryan Castle, and I'm talking to you about the Anchor app today. That's what this podcast is coming to you from. There are so many advantages to this app, it's hard to explain, but if you haven't heard about the Anchor app, it's the easiest way to make a podcast, so let me explain real quick. It's free. Then you have your creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or your computer. Anchor will then distribute your podcast for you so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make a podcast all in one place. So go to the Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started and keep your First Amendment rights going. What's up, everybody out there in the good old USA? This is your host of the One Stone Dude podcast, Ryan Castle. And it is 3 a.m., the witching hour, which I like to call it. Now, I only suggest that you listen to this if you're in the, if you're up in the middle of the night, you got nothing else better to do, or you're at work, because that's what I'm doing. I'm at work, and sometimes I wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning, and I got nothing to do, so I spend an hour out back in the gazebo, in the barbecue pit, smoking. Today we got a chocolate diesel with a little bit of White Widow extract, and that's what I'll be doing. Well, that's what I have done already. I'm going to enjoy my day at work. I'm at work till 6:30 in the morning, and I'll hit you up with some more thoughts. Other than that, relax, enjoy the music. Make some love if you can. Fuck if you can. Do all the types of shit. And if you're just by yourself, do your fucking thing, man. Put some porn on. It's only going to take a few minutes, right? Anyway, enjoy the rest of the show. I don't know what else is going to be on it. I'm making this up as I go. The idea just came to me while I was at work. Why not? Why not do a late night session? I might even have a guest on. So, anyway, enjoy the music. Relax, take care. What's up? Welcome to the next segment of the One Stone Dude podcast. I'm at my next stop, and it's 5 o'clock in the morning right now where I'm at. If this is the middle of the night for you and you got some fine looking lady laying next to you, do yourself a little bit of favor, especially if you're just getting home from work. Well, take a shower if you just got home from work first. Be real quiet about it. Try not to wake her up. And when you get out of the shower, spoon with her, lay side by side with her. And then slowly but surely, wake her up. Give her a little tickle. Let her know you're there. And then make it worth her waking up for. And if you can't go to sleep afterwards, make her something nice for breakfast. Anyway, enjoy the rest of the time. I gotta get back to work. All right, here's my last thought. I'm driving back to the office right now, and I'll be done for the rest of the day. I might try to get my barber on the podcast just to answer some questions. She's awesome. I might do it while she's cutting my hair. I have not been to a barber yet that's been able to cut my hair like this since I lived in Philly. So hopefully that's what I got in store next. I got to call and be the first one in line. But here's my thought. What if that officer that killed George Floyd wasn't an actual officer? What if his record was completely fabricated? What, after the trial said and done and over with, that they just whisk him off somewhere and pay him to be someplace for the rest of his life? And he doesn't have to worry about, because obviously he wasn't too concerned about family or friends when he was sitting there with his knee on the back of the guy's neck while the guy was begging for fucking help, begging for fucking mercy. What if he was the catalyst to pop the lid off the hot boiling pot that is society? You're talking about people that have been inside their homes or not being able to go do anything or go to work for the last 3-4 months. And all of a sudden, a black man gets killed over some bullshit, over something that didn't need to happen, but there obviously needed to be a reason. So what if that officer is a plant? That's for all you conspiracy theorists out there. Because this story kind of smells a little like bullshit. And if you review history, it'll show you about the riots that have happened in America. It'll show you who's involved in them. And it'll show you why. One of the last ones of that I can remember, I was 13 when Rodney King was attacked by police. And amongst all that, I mean, I don't think, not even, this country wasn't ready for it. If you look back at, shit, even the song, April 26, 1992. Go look at news, old news fucking stories from then. And judge for yourself. I mean, this is like history repeating itself all over again. Except the outcome was worse with the victim. You know, I never understood why police target African-American citizens. It's, you never hear about a white guy dying like that, being brutally attacked. Now, I've known people that are white that have been beaten up by the cops. I've known cops that have lost their shit. And a guy from my hometown. I don't know what the reason was, but I'm pretty sure it was almost justified. Got the guy in the back of the car and fucking, I guess he got kicked or spit on or something that provoked the officer. And the officer fucking teamed him up, hemmed him up in the back of the squad car. And I know the guy who's the cop, who was the cop. I've known him since I was probably 12, 13, 14 years old. He dated my sister and married my ex-girlfriend. And I don't know what has become of him. I do know that bullies become cops. I know one cop in particular in my hometown. I don't know if he's a cop or not anymore. He's probably in the higher ranks. This is a guy who stalked me pretty much with another guy, chased me around town on the weekends, all because he heard that I said I slept with his girlfriend. So I know what the mentality is of the people being recruited to be cops, and this guy shouldn't have been a cop. I watched him when he was 16 years old fight a 13-year-old just because he was the same size as him, and stepped in his way because a 13-year-old was a good friend of mine, and was like, nope, you're fighting me. And I don't know, John, if you're listening to this, hey man, I didn't forget that, and I really appreciate what you did. But it was unneeded. But you took an ass beating from me. Wasn't really an ass beating because you didn't look too bad. You held your own and gave some shots back. Anyway, enough about that. Cops have been doing terrible things lately in the name of their job. We had Jessica Robles and John Reed on the show on one of the episodes, and for the No Justice in Jersey. And basically, like, I don't even know what the situation is. I have to catch up with them. For all I know, they could be homeless. They had the cops, after Executive Order 106 was put into legislation by Governor Murphy of New Jersey, I had two of my friends removed from their homes after one of them lost their job because of COVID-19. Work slowed down for the other one, and they couldn't afford to stay at their apartment anymore. And they had them, they gave them a voucher for possibly the worst hotel in southern New Jersey. And they were only allowed to stay there so long, and John Reeds had posted a fundraiser on Facebook. So I hope you guys can look that up and donate to it if it's still going. But the cops came there with no problem, and John taped it. John recorded it and put it on Facebook. And of course, there was one cop who was being the badass, and there was one cop, like, he knew it was a moral injustice what he was doing. And they continued to get, they gave them 10 minutes to pack up what they could and get them out of that apartment. And now, we had an incident in Arizona where a guy, a real skinny African-American gentleman, was manhandled by cops that were way bigger than him, all because his 2 or 4 year old daughter walked out of a 99 cent store with a baby doll they didn't pay for accidentally. And then the media, to put a spin on it, tried to say this guy had problems with cops in the past. Of course he's had problems with cops in the past. This is Arizona, where mainly white people live. And the African-American community really doesn't stand a chance out here, even though our police chief is an African-American woman. Yet we still have incidents like that going on. And then George Floyd happened. So history shows us... Oh, shit. Huh. I just got beeped at by a really hot young lady. Anyhow... I am driving, by the way. So, history proves that cops have a problem with African Americans. It's obvious. I mean, you can just say you're doing your job, and that's a great cover and all, but, in the end, it comes down to, and I've said this before many times on the show, it comes down to what you think is the right thing to do, as opposed to doing your job. You know, that's it seems to be a moral dilemma for some people. I know my job told me to do something unlawful or unrealistic or something that goes against my better morals and judgment. Like, the most I've had to submit to so far was wearing a mask in a building. I wasn't a fan of it. I can't breathe in them. I get claustrophobic. I don't like things wrapped around my face. And I'm pretty sure that happens to a lot of people. But that's one of the few times I actually had to make a compromise. Now, if they told me that I have